Hi and welcome to How to Breakdance. My name is Mike Garcia, also known as Breaker. Now whether you're an avid breakdancer, a club dancer, a martial artist, or someone who's just looking for some new movements, this video has something for you. I've been a professional breakdancer now for over 16 years, contracted to do shows around the world including Las Vegas, Atlantic City, Miami, Moscow, Russia, and even Santiago, Chile. Also doing major television shows including David Letterman, Oprah Winfrey, Nickelodeon, and also Showtime Television. But this video isn't about me, it's about teaching you. So let's get started. Swipe is started in the seated position, bringing your right arm over your body into full push-up position, following left arm over the body again, back to seated position. Again, right arm over body, push-up position, left arm following through, back into seated position. Step two is done just like step one, in seated position. Bring right arm over body, this time fully rotate all the way around, following through with your left arm on the ground. Right all the way over, body continuing, left arm placed on the ground. Step three is also started in seated position. This time bring your right leg up to your body, lift your body up, bring your right arm over, to push-up position with right leg still bent, back down to first position. Right arm over, right leg still bent, left arm back down, first position. In step four, you're going to practice raising your body into the air while in push-up position. Bring your right arm over into push-up position while you're placing all your weight onto your hands. Right arm over, push your position, weight onto your hand. In step five, you're going to raise your left leg into the air. Do steps one, two, and three while you revolve over your left leg. The quicker and tighter your swipe is, the better balance you will have. Double-legged swipes are done just like one-legged swipes, except bringing both legs up to your chest, lifting up your body so that it makes a table, and then revolving around your body by doing steps 1, 2, and 3 of the one-legged swipes. Again, both legs revolving around the body, landing at the same time. Step one, right leg under left leg under right leg, left hand down, right leg back, left under, left hand down, right leg back, left leg back, right under, left hand down, right, left. Now in step 2 we'll be practicing the same motion as in step 1 with quicker, more fluent movement. Notice the key positions in the 6 steps. Right leg under left, and left leg bends, then right leg bends, then left leg sweeps under right. And then back to first position. Again, it's right leg under left, and left leg bends, then right leg bends, then left leg sweeps under right. And then back to first position. Here we have it in slow motion. Right leg under left, right leg bends, left leg sweeps under right leg. When doing the 6 step, make sure you keep your body tight and centered. As your steps become quicker, your movements will become much more fluent. From standing position, right leg out, left arm up, left leg out, right arm up, right leg out, left arm up, left leg out, right arm up. Step 2 from standing position, same as step 1, with a forward bounce. Forward bounce right leg, forward bounce left leg. Remember to continue raising opposite arm as the leg you step with. Step 3, same as step 1 and 2. And longer strides in your balance, getting more comfortable with the movements. Position. You'll place your left leg over your right leg over your left, and a slight twist to the body. Again, right over left, land left, right. Left over right, land right, left. Right leg behind left knee, then left knee, down to the ground to 6-step position. Again, right leg behind left knee, then left knee, down into 6-step position. Thank you. Step 1 with right arm extended, bend fingers, knuckle, wrist, elbow, shoulders. Again, bend fingers, knuckle, wrist, elbow, shoulders. You might want to say it in your head. Fingers, knuckle, wrist, elbow, shoulders. Again, fingers, knuckle, wrist, elbow, shoulders. Concentrate on each bend of the move. Again, fingers, knuckles, wrist, elbow, shoulders. Step 2 is the shoulder shrug, just like when you say, I don't know. Now just concentrate on lifting one shoulder at a time. Right, then left. Step 3 is the opposite of step 1. So now you bend your elbow, wrist, knuckles, fingers. Elbow, wrist, knuckles, fingers in an outwardly motion. Elbow, wrist, knuckles, fingers. Elbow, wrist, knuckles, fingers. In step 4, you will connect steps 1, 2, and 3 all together. Again, you might want to repeat the moves as you do them. Fingers, knuckles, wrist, elbow, shoulder, shoulder, elbow, wrist, knuckles, fingers. As you get more comfortable with the wave, it'll start looking more fluid-like, going through your body, arm to arm. Step 1 of the second wave from standing position. Raise right arm to left arm. Trace down right arm through body. Down leg. Lift up left knee. Down left knee. Through body again. Back up right arm. Again. Down right arm. Through body. Down leg. Up knee. Down knee. Through body. Back up right arm. Step 2, we practice what we learned in the first wave. Again, more fluid-like in the right arm, all the way down the body. Through the right arm, all the way down, left leg, all the way through back. Again, tracing the wave all through your body. Step 3, we work on getting very fluid, going through your body, all the way up. A little bit quicker, also using the body as part of the wave. Step 1, right foot forward, left foot back. Left foot forward, right foot back. Alternating them with a snapping motion at the very end of the movement. Same movement, concentrate at the very end of the motion, at the very end of the movement. The quick snap. toe, down on heel, on left toe. Right toe, heel, left toe. Right toe, heel, left toe. Step two, right toe down, heel, lifting up weight, place it down on left toe, right toe down, heel, lifting up on weight, step on the left toe, right toe down, heel, lifting up weight, step on left toe. Step three, right toe down, placing down on heel, slide left foot onto left toe, slide right foot over. Right toe, heel, slide left foot, right foot back. Step four, concentrate on sliding motion and the shifting of weight from one leg to another. Moving your body in wave-like motions helps create the illusion of gliding. Step one. You must find something to wear over your hand, like a towel or a knee pad. Place the knee pad over your hand, like so. Place your elbow right into your midsection of your stomach. Again, place your elbow right into the midsection of your stomach. Lean on top of your elbow. In step two, you place your elbow into your midsection of your body and then lift up your legs, placing all the weight on top of your elbow and hand. Again, elbow into midsection, raise legs, weight onto your wrist and hand. This is also a great exercise for conditioning your wrist, getting used to the full body weight on top of your hand. In step three, you'll be doing steps one and two, but now practicing the sweeping motion that creates the movement for the hand spin. Again, steps one and two with a sweeping motion for the hand spin. Step 1, started in seated squatted position, raise right arm overhead followed by your left. Again, right arm overhead followed by left, looking at left hand. Right arm, left, looking at left hand. In step 2, you'll be doing as in step 1, but this time throwing your leg over and doing a side cartwheel. Step one, leg over, side cartwheel. Again, step one,
leg over, side cartwheel. In step 3, you'll be doing the same as step 2, but this time kicking your legs directly over your head. Again, keep your eyes looking at your left hand as you go over, keeps your body straight. One more time, step 2, keep your eyes on your left hand, body over straight. Once started in seated position, roll back, place hands behind head. This is also how you will gain your momentum for the kip up. Notice the way the hands are positioned and the direction they're positioned. In step 2, you'll be doing just as step 1, except this time kicking legs forward, up, and under, landing on upper shoulder blades. Again, forward, up, and under. In step 1, lay flat on your back with legs open in a V position. Now rotate legs around while rolling on upper middle section of your body. Make sure you keep your legs open because this will keep your motion going in the window. In step 2, we'll be practicing the upper section of the windmill. Place left hand beside head to protect face and roll upon your right elbow. Step 3, you want to put on some protective clothing like a jacket or sweatshirt to protect your shoulders and your body while practicing the windmill. In step 4, you will be doing what is called a turntable. This is done first by placing right arm into midsection of the body and stabilizing with the left arm. Keep legs straight, arms straight, tip shoulder down into the movement, and do step 1. In step 5, you'll be doing steps 4, 2, and 1. After the first revolution of the windmill, place your elbow again into your lower stomach, like in step 2. This will allow clearance enough for your legs so that they can pass under you. Remember, keep your legs in V formation. The windmill is like doing continuous turntables.
And there you have it, Volume 1 of How to Breakdance. For those of you that have mastered the movements, congratulations. But remember, practice makes perfect. So no matter what you do or what you learn, practice, practice, and practice. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you on Volume 2.
please say hello to Mike Garcia. All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Please say hello to Mike Garcia. Please say hello to Mike Garcia.
And there you have it, Volume 1 of How to Breakdance. I'd like to take this time now, and there you have it. I get it. All right, here we go.